Unfortunately, my brothers, you don't see this just yet. I just put the delay on and you will see this right after 3 minute mark. So this won't be live anymore, but there will be delay a little bit. Dusty, you leading the clan war 1-0, and now it's all about Luolis to win versus Plusk and maybe tie up the clan war 1-1 situation. Enigma looked really strong in game 1. Mirso didn't play a bad game at all, but unfortunately he got harassed so well that he was delayed in what he tried, and the attack came a little bit too early for our finished jerk, and that's unfortunate. So the clan war will end when either team has 3 wins, and this team, Dusty EU, here in the right up corner of the map, is having 1-0 lead over his opponents, and Plusk is the one that is playing from Dusty EU in the second map. It's a Protoss again, so Dusty EU putting up like the best to the table today, or best of the house to the table. Meanwhile, here in the down left side of the map, we have Micromaniacs, Luolis. Finnish team needs to get some wins, because if Finnish team is losing this, then the score will be 2-0, and then the Finnish team is like back against the wall and needs to win 2 games in a row, so that's not an ideal place for sure. But the Finnish team is also sending a great player to play this very important second game, and it's gonna be Luolis here in the blue shift. Meanwhile, Plusk is not gonna be seeing anything in the Luolis main, because Luolis has walled off the ramp, and there's no going there. This SCV takes some hits from the probe that it doesn't die. Meanwhile, oh, Luolis just goes with it and starts to peel. Oh no, this is looking day. Oh no, 5 HP left from that one. Plusk is gonna be doing standard expansion here on that. Meanwhile, Marine comes out. Will it kill the probe? Ooh, one shot. This game is already full of one shot in things, or not one shot in things, but things running out without like getting the last hit. First, the SCV from Luolis, it kind of flirted with the idea to die in the game already, in the start of the game. Here you see this dangerous fella. We have to check that one out, because that guy is looking an opportunity to kill himself, it seemed like. I fear for his life. Please call 911, because depression isn't like thing to joke about. It's an dangerous thing to have, and it's a dangerous mind state to be. So that fellow, that needs some help. Meanwhile, this probe having a little bit of same thing, but because this probe is moving so fast, I think that probe is having like more the idea that, hey, I'm still living, so I'm gonna live fullest my life to the fullest. I'm gonna do all the things I wanted to do before I die and tell my loved ones that I love them. Meanwhile, Plusk making a Stargate. Oracle about to be starting up. Luolis is actually gonna be making Hellion, so the Oracle might be actually the one that makes critical damage already, because if Luolis is gonna make 4 or 6 Hellions, there won't be like anything in the main that suits the Oracle, and that's really dangerous spot to be in. And that's one of the reasons why people, even though this build has a great potential for Terran players to do a huge amounts of damage, it's so freaking vulnerable against Oracles. So that, yeah, and even Luolis gonna be going for medivac first. So now, oh, actually, Plusk is not gonna be doing anything with the first Oracle. He just stays it, let it stay in his base, and he's gonna build up energy and do some stasis rap things later on. So this is actually a good thing for Luolis for now, because Luolis don't lose like every worker in his main, and that's a good thing. That's a good thing indeed. Meanwhile, medivac for Luolis coming up. finishing, Luol is taking 6 marines and gonna fly away with them. Meanwhile, how many Hellions they are? They are 6 Hellions and 6 marines, and Luol is just gonna do some double pronged attack over here. There's actually 3 adepts in the natural. Usually you see Protoss making more of those Stalkers here on out, but let's see how adepts fare against those Hellions, because those Hellions are gonna enter to the natural. Blask haven't walled in his natural. The Hellions are a little bit late. Meanwhile, here happens things. Oracle is dying. And is the Phoenix dying? Well, everything is dying. Luol is looking bad. No, he's not here. 6 Hellions going to the natural line. Line them up. 6 probes dying. Will they die even more? 7. 10. Go, Phoenix boy. Do it. 12. 13. Already crucial damage to the mineral line of Blask. Blask was thinking that, hey, I defended that medivac drop rather well, but then the Hellions appeared and killed 50 probes, and that's a huge amount of damage for sure. Meanwhile, Luol is not gonna be making the 3rd CC. 3rd CC is for the noobs. It's so last season, it's so hard of the swarm. Nowadays, Terrans are doing all about 1 or 2 base pressures. Luol's cheese tank is on position, but wait, those adepts are might be doing some damage. Meanwhile, the follow-up is coming. There are cloak banshees coming to join the fray, and meanwhile Blask sees that starboard is researching something, and he smells blood in the water. But is it too late though? Banshee already entering into the natural line of Blask, and even more probes to be killed. Meanwhile adepts shade in and kill actually many workers as well, but the Banshee did die because there was an oracle that could scout the Banshee, and both of the players did actually quite decent amount of damage here on out. 6 SCVs lost for Luolis and 90 probes lost for Blask, and Blask is still 1 worker ahead. This is Protoss macro for you, so yeah, nothing has decided yet, but Luol is obviously doing nice amount of damage, but it's still all about doing that one pressure later on. This this game has been more or less only building up that one push that he wants to win the game with. Meanwhile, Luol is gonna be sending 1 Banshee over to the main of Blask, but there's that OP structure. It's called Sealed Battery. And this Banshee won't be doing anything, even though it can, it's gonna be left out there. Yes, you can see, no probes lost. That's some balance for you for sure. 1 structure to kill them all. Meanwhile, Luolis steam is gonna be completed. There's a combat shield already as well completed. So Luolis is gonna be going for this 0-0 time in attack with the steam. And he also has 3 tanks, so Luolis at least wants to kill the third base. But meanwhile, there's adepts defending that, and adepts are really good units in early game, especially against marines, and they are only 2 marauders. So this is looking rather dangerous. Well, maybe for the both players, but for Luolis especially, because these tanks they can be lifted up by those phoenixes, and they are just enough phoenixes that they can do it. Meanwhile, the adepts, they are coming up. Now Luolis needs to micro his harder. Ooh, he's actually steaming, but that was a fake call. Fake shading from Protoss players, so Luolis losing quite a bit of energy for those medivacs, but perhaps he's gonna be given some time. He actually stings up again. Meanwhile, tanks, they're coming a little bit closer. There are 2 bunkers, so many adepts actually coming up. And now it's all about Luolis not shooting those fellows afar. Meanwhile, there you go, and there's an epic fight happening. We have no idea. Meanwhile, the reserve of Luolis, the reinforcements come here, and Luolis is microwing his heart out. Tanks are being lifted by those phoenixes. And still, the bunker is alive, and it's full of marines, and there are a couple of those tanks alive as well. But Blask is having actually quite hard time versus the army of Luolis. Luolis is attacking quite brilliantly. That was really a nice micro in the battle that happened. There was a microing happening in the three different sides in that that fight. So damn. Meanwhile, the pressure is still on. One alone punker is over there. Well, one bugger doesn't feel much, but it actually is, because phoenixes cannot lift the bunker up, and it will provide more and more damage. Meanwhile, Liberator comes here as well. I wonder, should Duelist... nice casting. Oracle died to the Marines, and that's a huge thing as well, because that Oracle has a power to kill some Marines if given time needed. Meanwhile, Marauders killing a pylon. There's a 20, almost like 25 working lead for Plusk, so every second Plusk can get is good thing for him for sure. Meanwhile, Plusk is actually making robotics facility and robotics pay, but I'm pretty sure the game will be decided before that. Luolis is gonna micro his heart out. This Liberator getting some good shots in the Adepts. So many Adepts actually, and will he say it? No, he doesn't, but Luolis has to go back. These tanks are actually not shooting the Nexus because they are not in the range of Nexus, and that's not an ideal place for sure. Now the Nexus needs to be killed. Meanwhile, Plusk is gonna be taking one Nexus more, and he's gonna be... Ooh, the Sadin, he cancels them so early that Luolis can pick up that Nexus easily, but new Nexus is about to be coming and joining the fray. Meanwhile, some harassment coming on from Plusk, and meanwhile Luolis still gonna be going further and further. Luolis actually lifted up his main command center into the third base because he didn't have money to make one himself. This Liberator will die as soon as one Phoenix sneezes into it. This Sage won't be happening, but Luolis army has taken a little bit of damage for that massive steam, and there you come. Luolis just running back. He's not trading at all against those Adepts. Now luckily there are four medivacs. They heal quite a little bit. Luolis gonna go further and further in the map. Ooh, the first disruptor is about to be coming, so Luolis is having a little bit of timer. He needs to trade, he needs to kill his opponent's army before those disruptors comes, and Luolis is going and not going and is going. Luolis can kill this if it's a steam to win Luolis. Oh no, the first disruptor is about to be finishing up. These Marines, they will die onto those Adepts that are warping in for sure. And there's the ball. There's the disruptor, the ball of destruction, and this is looking really dangerous now for both of the players at the same time. Meanwhile, this harassment of Plusk is doing huge amount of damage, preventing the mining from the second base. Actually, might Luolis gets that disruptor. That's a huge thing. Luolis could actually kill the Sading happens into the tanks, but it's a bad Sading. Luolis has a way bigger army, and this game might be over here, or maybe not. At least the army supply from Plusk is so small, 21 against 80 of Luolis. If Luolis just don't die to disruptors, that this game should be over, and Plusk losing even more of the Adepts. He did lost another Nexus. Meanwhile, scan goes from Luolis, so Luolis knows that there's no disruptor waiting for the Impa shot in the high ground, and some Liberators, they are uncontested. There's anything, and that ball, oh no, that was a huge shot, killing like 20 supply worth of units, but Luolis still having so big army supply that does it matter at all? Medivacs, they don't have energy, and what are warping, so many Adepts warping at the same time. Luolis sniping down the robotics facility. There are some units from Luolis in the low ground, and these medivacs not having energy is a little bit of an issue, but these Liberators, they offer a safe place to zone in against those Adepts. Meanwhile, Plusk having 6 army supply, will totally forget about that. Now it's 20, but these Adepts, they warping in the kind of strange place. Meanwhile, this should be given time for Luolis to go. Actually, Luolis should like lift up both of the Liberators and his units and seat up both of the mineral lines. Now this looks something that maybe the Protoss player can actually get him back to, because there's now Phoenix shooting those Liberators, and there are only Marauders here, so there's no Marines to shoot down those Liberators. And Luolis, what might be Luolis be doing here? Is he gonna rally his units? Seems like he will, and now Luolis has a huge army again, and the fight sounds are on. Liberators eating up in a nice position again. killing more and more of the adepts. This fight, this will never end. It seems like Protoss has endless warpings, it feels like. And he's mining huge amount of minerals from his natural, and he gets some gas from the main as well. But seems like maybe Luolis has enough, maybe Luolis has too much. And there comes the GG, Blaskis out from the game, and Micromaniacs is gonna tie the series into 1-1. Ooh, nice. Very nice, very nice. So nicely played by Luolis, and we're gonna be going to the third map of the clan war next. It's gonna be John versus Factballs, and that means that we're gonna be having TVT, if my memory serves right. And then Stun versus Temper, we're gonna be seeing that as well, definitely. If this clan war goes to the fifth game, both of the players are able to use a Joker on that map, and both themes will revive one of their players into that decisive match. But that means that the score has to be 2-2 when four players first has played. Oh, these are like the older, like, yeah, old map pool here, it seems like, because we're gonna have Stasis Lee. Actually, well, Blue Shift ain't in the current map pool as well, so maybe I should have been awake already on that regard. But well. Stasis Lee is the map. And yeah, it's TVT. John, the American Terran, seems like he's not been playing in EU that much, but Factballs has played in EU that much, and Factballs should be taking the win. I feel it's time for Finnish to show the world that we know how to play some StarCraft. Well, Serral went and won the BlitzCon, but well, it was only a BlitzCon, and this is Alpha Team League, so yeah. So clan war is situated in 1-1 situation, and here in the right side of Stasis Lee we have John. I'm not sure, is that the little son from Robin Hood, or like big John from the from the scientific films we are watching when we are alone in the internet. And in the left side of Stasis Lee, we have the Finnish player, it is Factballs. Factballs and John. That's rather pervert, one might think. Yeah, John playing in the red and Factballs playing in the blue, as you are supposed to be, because it's a Finnish Terran. And, well, American Terran playing as red is kind of like communist thinking. Like, you know, Russia is red, Soviet Union was red, and now we have an American that's playing red. So that's like, that's too much to handle for me. I cannot understand how the political situation of the world is going right now. Global politics, well. But hey, jokes aside. Now we're on serious business. This is the third map of the clan war, and Factballs needs to bring the victory for the home team. Which of them is the home team? That's rather like, maybe it's in our minds. Let's say that this is Piet's casting, actually, if you didn't like catch that. Yeah, I'm Piet as fuck towards the Finnish team. John, trying to see if there are proxies around, but Factballs ain't not into that. Factballs is more into like getting balls deep into opponent's face with a nice macro and bio play. Factballs actually isn't taking his guys off from the gas, so he's gonna be making a starboard, and is actually John doing the same thing It feels like. This is rather strange, but some kind of a proxy starboard thingy from John. But Thakpols is not making a proxy and he's making a starboard in his main, so we're gonna see how this plays out. In theory, Thakpols, if he just don't get blindsided, he should be in a good position when both of the players have two Reapers and one Hellion. It's time to go. John is the one who's willing to go even further. Thakpols is waiting, and John, will he go on? And Thakpols actually saw the army, or he should have seen the army, but did he actually see it? Seems like not. John will trap a little bit of Thakpols' army, and we have lots of micro. Thakpols is in a little bit of trouble, but the extra Reaper comes, and that means the Hellion will die, and the last soul survivor Reaper, it will be saved. So the unit lost actually will be same for both players. Thakpols having that closer rally point, so it helped him quite a bit, even though that battle started really bad for him. This cyclone, is that trap? It's a trap! That cyclone, oh no. That will be an issue if a tank goes there, for example, and it's gonna be requiring micro from Thakpols' side and other things. Meanwhile, both of the players making a reparator. This slipper, where that, ooh, no, ooh, this dangerous thing that every time when the cyclone locks into the cyclone and the other cyclone doesn't. Meanwhile, John, did he actually see the cyclone? At cyclone with his reparator, because he moved that reparator quite a bit, so I guess Thakpols didn't see that, but Thakpols should be alert, and Thakpols is actually having two of the cyclones. Meanwhile, Liberator coming to see it, but they are missile turret, and John is not paying attention to it, and it's just gonna be going. Meanwhile, the Liberator of Thakpols just killing the SCV that was built in command center. Well, that's annoying as fuck when you're a Terran player that's building things. That's kind of the place where you start remembering that Terran is the only race that cannot build their CCs like wherever they want. And meanwhile, actually, where is the Cyclone of Chance? It's over there. Let's see if that Reparator actually is able to snipe the siege tank, and then Thakpols would be coming into the natural. That would be a huge thing for sure, but actually a second tank comes. Thakpols, this is dangerous. This is so freaking dangerous, and meanwhile, Liberator not doing anything but the Cyclones. They actually will take one shot, but Liberator will finish that tank for sure. But Thakpols will lose both of the Liberators. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no 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 no. So now that went perfectly almost well, John. Meanwhile, Thakpols, will he get Thakpols not paying attention? He's actually gonna be taking Odo lock on into the Marines, and Thakpols' cyclone is threatened to die. Losing two Liberators and two Cyclones, well, he killed two tanks, that's a nice thing for sure, but those are expensive units for sure, and that Reaper goes to die as well. Well, when you look at the work account, it's almost the same for both players, but the army supplies is the issue here. John having 10 Marines, Thakpols having 1, and that's kind of the issue, you might say. It was a little bit eager for Thakpols to go in the natural like that, and he's gonna pay the iron price for that. Meanwhile, the cyclone from Thakpols is gonna see that John is in the middle of the map, and most likely is gonna be moving out. Auto lock on for both. Actually, the cyclone of John didn't even die. It actually has 5 kills, that cyclone, so he's the MVP of this game for sure, and maybe MVP of this clan war as well. Ooh, another tank comes for Thakpols. Maybe that is enough to help him out. It's kind of strange that neither of the players have done not a single Viking, but now there are actually two about to come for Thakpols, and there comes a scan from Thakpols, and that's a good thing for sure. Meanwhile, this tank is in perfect place to hold this off. It will start to shoot with the first tank, and there you go. Scan ain't even available for John, so John just lost One tank and other almost died, but he's gonna go to the natural. There's one tank awaiting and one medivac dies. Those are steamed marines, but they are so low in health. Actually, even the medivac dies, so if Fakbos is fighting back, Fakbos going strong. That went perfectly for Fakbos, and now the army supplies are in Fakbos' favor. But Son already finishing up his third command center. I don't think that Fakbos has even started one, so Fakbos needs to apply pressure, and pressure he is applying for sure. Fakbos having the air advantage here, and it's huge, but he has only one tank. Well, John has only one tank as well. But still, it's rather hard to go against the steam player that has... Well, both of the players have steam. And soon, John Auxilly will be having a combat shield as well. So this looks rather dangerous spot to attack if you don't have combat shield for. So will John use steam? That's a question. No, he does not. So the Vikings will survive. Fakbos actually leaves his army right there. I wonder what he's thinking to do with one tank and like 50 marines. Ooh, there comes a scan from John, and Vakbos needs to go back. Actually, his tank is left. He's left there and it will die. Well, that's really unfortunate. Really unfortunate for sure. John having a huge economy lead now, so Vakbos needs to do something fast. And now, because opponent having one CC more and more workers than you. But it's hard to see a situation where Fakbos can go and attack, as TVT kind of favors the defender. And this map, especially the defender, has an advantage. But Fakbos putting all eggs in one basket and loading up his four medivacs, and he's gonna be going to the natural of John's, but John is totally prepared against this. Oh no. This is looking so dangerous. Well, John might still be off guard by this, because Fakbos is gonna be seeing that. Now, if Fakbos just don't go to the missile turrets, he actually does, and that's one medivac goes down. Will the second one go down? Well, at least one tank survives, but there might have been some tanks in the medivac that was lost. And now you can see that the army supplies is the same for both players. But Fakbos is kinda in awkward positions to take the fight in. Here we see John coming up. His marines are actually so freaking low, but seems not that's not affecting the fight all that much. John will clear this up for sure, and with that missile turret also Getting one medivac down as well. So now the worker count is quite even, but John is still leading with that one command center and having a little bit greater army at the moment as well. Making those three missile turrets was a good decision for John, one might say. And John actually making already another command center. So now the situation will be that there's four command centers versus a player that has two command centers in favor of John. And let's see what Fakbos is gonna be doing. Meanwhile, John is actually building more medivacs right now. Okay. And the army supply is even. But Fakbos feeling the urge to do the pressure here. He might attack into place where he should not be attacking. Meanwhile, John, will he retake this turret, this tower? Seems like he will. Fakbos abandons the plan, and the middle of the map goes now into John's control, and that's a huge thing here for sure. Meanwhile, a medivac drop came from Fakbos, but this drop seems to be not making anything. Killing one tank, and well, six SCVs, that's rather okay thing, but losing that much of an army without getting rather not anything away from it is really bad. And John scans and sees Fakbos' position. He actually sees that there aren't no third CC around, and John will be landing his tank, and they will see us behind the tanks or the debris. But Fakbos luckily does have those Vikings Backbone's gonna be losing at least one tank here. Now there are actually five tanks in a pretty awkward position. And there comes a scan, and there comes a scan from John as well. Meanwhile, John already mining from the gold base as well, and from the third base. And John actually lifting up his tanks. But these Vikings are gonna be chasing those medivacs down. And those, these tanks are not still gonna go anywhere. And let's see if Thugballs can do something for those medivacs. But seems like these medivacs ain't like that low. And John will most likely, save his tanks. Losing five tanks would have maybe changed the game. But now, actually, this is the time where Thugballs needs to end the game right here. And this is the time where Thugballs can maybe do it, because he has a little bit of greater army now. Maybe he's gonna siege up to the planetary. Seems like he will. Will he be surprised that that actually is over there? Steam will come. No repair just yet. I think Thugballs will totally wreck this planetary off, and that's a small thing. Well, not a small thing, but that's not something that will put the game in Thugballs' favor. And now John is all army is in position to defend his third base, and this still looks quite great for John, because when those two upgrades hit, well, that will be something for sure. Thugballs, this is looking scary. So scary. Those medivacs, they go and try to go somewhere else. Meanwhile, John seems like he will be going for a base raid. Well, John doesn't know that this will eventually be base raid, but yeah, it will be a base raid. Two liberators over here, but only one tank. I wish there would be more tanks, but there aren't, and scan goes down for Thugballs, and there you go. Ooh, actually, that medivac has those two tanks, and let's hope that won't die. Meanwhile, John gonna keep going up from the ramp. Liberator trying to do the best they can, but there are way too many Marines, and only one tank cannot do anything for those Marines, so Thugballs' main will totally be killed off against those Marines soon. The two upgrades will be finished for John as well, and Thugballs having only 1-1 is putting him really bit behind in upgrades. And here this tank needs to do some work. It actually does do some work. And what is John gonna be doing? He's gonna be flying his medivacs, but Thugballs has Marines with him, and he actually kills a couple of those medivacs, and actually those tanks getting sieged in a pretty awkward position, but only one tank for Thugballs at the moment. So actually Thugballs killed quite a bit of John's army defending that ramp so well. So maybe there's still some hope for Thugballs, but there are still so many CCs though. So and actually, does Thugballs have anything on the map? Not seems like he doesn't have anything. And Thugballs lifting up his structures is gonna go and try to find a place for somewhere else to land them in. There are so many SCVs still there, but they will die a horrible death against this army of John's. Meanwhile, John is lifting up things from him as well. Thugballs will totally snipe at least that orbital, but there are so many orbitals. Thugballs still needs to be sniping, and Thugballs needs to go over there as well. Let's hope he will do that. And Thugballs, what is his plan here? There are many different approaches you can do in a base raid situation like this, and one of them is trying to hunt down your opponent's CC and other things. Thugballs luckily sees that there are command center over there, and he actually sees that the SCVs are moving to the down side of the map, so maybe that will alert Thugballs a little bit. No, Thugballs doesn't actually send his units over there. He needs to kill those four Paraxes, because John has way better upgrades. And John, that's the reason why John cannot have an army or a decent army against Thugballs just right now. But seems like Thugballs, he actually sees that command center, so he will snipe that down as well. John is still having this command center over here and this command center over there. So well, this is a game still, and dreams are alive for both of the players still. But John is looking strong, making Marines at the time, four at the time. Meanwhile, Thugballs ain't doing not a single unit, and Vac Balls, well, of course, not having the vision that we are having, is gonna put his army over here, and is now he's gonna be flying with the two medivacs at least somewhere. Oh, Vac Balls actually has another command center ready as well. John necessarily don't know about that command center, and Vac Balls actually he will see that they are CC over there, and that's actually the only CC where John is mining from. But John having 30 workers comparing to one worker of Vac Balls, but now Vac Balls is gonna be killing some workers for sure, and these workers, they try to fight against that. Will Vac Balls be able to get the CC? He definitely will. John doesn't go and try even defend that. There aren't any CCs over there, over that side, so John will soon be out of minerals and gas, and he cannot make any more of the army. But John actually has 53 army supply against Vac Balls 47, and he has way better upgrades as well. Vac Balls killing... Ooh, Vac Balls, oh no, Vac Balls gonna go a little bit too deep, and he does lose a medivac full of units, and that's a huge loss for sure. Now John has the upper hand when it comes to the army side, but that's the only command center for John at the moment, so this game is rather awkward, one might say. But still, John is so ahead in the upgrades, like three upgrades ahead, plus one have for those tanks, and 2-2 against 1-1. But Vac Balls is having one tank more than his opponent. So Vac Balls is gonna be needing an insane position for his army, for sure. And Vac Balls doesn't have the vision of the map for sure, so he doesn't know that is John mining or not. Well, John knows, obviously, that he is not mining. Well, this might be the position Vac Ball needs. The tanks are sieged, and there goes Vac Balls. Ooh, those tanks, they get some decent shots on those marines. But, so many bio still left for John, and John lifting his bio off Vac Balls. Vac Balls did, like, put the army supplies in the same position. It's kind of strange that John doesn't fly his orbital anywhere. So that means that there aren't no income for John, even though he's having still more workers than Vac Balls. He's afraid to land that orbital anywhere, but he will land that over there. Meanwhile, John is gonna be coming down from that ramp. Vac Balls has a medivac over there. Will that die? No, it doesn't. Tanks will actually kill even more of the marines, and that's a huge thing for John. Meanwhile, John is gonna be going and start mining. But Vac Balls is gonna be sending a drop and will kill a couple of supply depots and other good stuff as well. But John is actually shooting a racks over there, nothing more. Meanwhile, this factory gonna be give vision for Vac Balls, and even killing one tank is so huge, and killing another tank. Well, that leaves only one tank for Vac Balls. What the fuck is going on in this game? Vac Balls might still take this game. Look at the army supply, 41 to Vac Balls, and 22 for John. And Vac Balls, is he gonna go? He's gonna go and deny the mining from John. So John is in a world of troubles right now. And Steam to win says, Vac Balls, you don't need SCVs. John will GG out, and Vac Balls will win the game. Oh my god, that should not be happening. But well, in a game of base trade, anything can happen, and Vac Balls puts Micromaniacs in 2-1 lead, and that was a TVT, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. Oh, and John is actually frightened that GG, you guys win. 1-3, Stun isn't here, so GG, so Micromaniacs will win with wins from Vac Balls and Luolis. So what a clan for, unfortunate to have the win like in no show in the fourth map. But still, that was insane TVT for sure. Wow. So nice, so nice. Yeah. So, here we are. This was a fast stream. Huge thanks for Faxballs putting like private message that there's a clan for and there's no streamer. This was a pleasure to come to stream for sure. Seeing Finnish mates winning a clan war. That's awesome. Because look at those fellows. Blask. Actually, it shows that, Blask was Grandmaster. Enigma was Grandmaster as well. So John was the only one of the opposing team that wasn't Grandmaster. So Stun didn't show. So that means we did win the war. We are the champions of the world. Let's put that actually on. And celebrate a bit.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence.
Nice done. Nicely done, Luolis and Faxballs. You're the man. You're the man.
And bad mistakes.
And you are the man. Oh my god. Like what other cannot see that? My friends.
And we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions
of the world. Yeah, and that was it. This was a really, really shorty stream, but still short, but not without emotions. So Finnish fellows winning 3-1 against Dust Gaming, and that's huge. That's huge for sure, as we are on Micromaniacs is more of an amateur team, and I wonder was this like the first even win for this season. I'm not that sure, but yeah, win we did. And there we see the scores, how the Alpha Team League season 13 has gone for Micromaniacs. And yeah, this is like the first real victory, it seems like. Or what the fuck, I'm actually, no, that was amateur league. So yeah, here we are in the right place. So 4 losses, a nail biter against Force Gaming, but still a loss through 2-0, 2-3, and now win over Dust Gaming 3-1, and that's the first for the season. So nicely done, guys, and nicely done, Temper. Temper was so good that the opponent felt that it's not necessary to even play the game, and the opponent didn't show up. So yeah, thanks for watching, mates. Thanks for having me casting the CV. This was awesome, and congratulations for the win, Torille. And I go to sauna. So have a nice evening, everyone, and see you later. Bye.